guys, welcome to another song lesson with me, Rex Pearson, from rexpearson.com. If you're liking these lessons, don't forget you can head over to the website and sign up, and it's completely free at the moment. Well, it's completely free, don't worry about it. What we're going to be learning today is a new song by the Foo Fighters called Rope. I say new, maybe when you're watching this it's not new, but at the moment it's very new. Great song, great tune for intermediate players. It's got all sorts in there. It's even got an advanced section for people looking at learning the solo part. We're going to be learning the whole song, every part, starting from the very beginning, which is the intro. And we're going to play it like it is in the recording. So the first part is an intro, and I'm going to teach you the shapes that you need to do with your left hand, and also the strumming pattern, and how it sort of links together to create the full intro. And once you've learned the actual intro, it's very easy to learn the next part, which is where the verse comes in, the first words, and it repeats throughout the whole song. So it's quite easy once you get the first part. So let's start then with the intro and this strumming part. Let's go. Third finger on the 7th fret on the G string, that note. First finger on the 5th fret on the B string. Play them together. Sounds a bit horrible together, but it works in the track. That's the kind of sound that you're going to get. That's the first shape. All you do is hit that once. The second shape, you leave the first finger in place, you keep it there, it'll help with the change. Fourth finger goes down on the 7th fret on the high E string. So you've got those two notes. That's the second shape. So you've got third shape goes like this. First finger's gonna drop down to the 3rd fret on the high E. Third finger is gonna take the place of where the first finger was on the 5th fret on the B string. Great sounding chord on its own, not, but it does work in the track, and that is what they actually play. Play them together, and you play it again. So you've got three shapes. Right, so once you've got that first intro, it's then a new guitar enters into the mix, the lead guitar, and that's what I'm going to teach you guys now, because that's the bit that sort of takes over. It's pretty much the same shapes as what you've just learned. It just plays around with them a little bit more and makes it a little bit more difficult to fret correctly. First thing you want to get is the strumming pattern. So if I play the very first part, it sounds like this. The strumming pattern is what you need to get first before you attempt the rest of it. Watch what I'm doing with the down and the up strokes. You need to make sure that you finish on an up stroke. Slow down the tempo so it sounds like this. And then gradually speed it up till you get it. When you can do it like that, then you're ready for the shapes. Don't attempt the shapes until you get that strumming pattern first. That's a warning for you, otherwise you're going to find it really difficult to move on. Okay, shape then. You're going to have to change it a little bit. Third finger is going to be on the 7th fret. Fourth finger is going to be on the 7th fret. And they're on the D and the G. Those two strings. And what you do is you play around with the 4th finger, and then the 1st finger comes down on the 4th fret. And what you do is you sort of do a strum. So you release the 4th finger, put the 1st finger down, then you put the 4th finger back up, and that's on the, the 4th finger back down, and it's on the upstroke. So what you've got is, that's the first shape. That's probably the hardest shape of this whole verse. Then you move on to the next shape, which is exactly the same as the intro. First finger on the fifth fret on the B string. Fourth finger on the 7th fret on the high E. And you do the same strumming pattern, which is why we worked on it. And you do this whole dropping down. You release the 4th finger and put it back on. So you've got So, the two shapes together. That's what you should have so far. Next shape is exactly the same as the intro. Third finger on the fifth fret of the B string, fourth finger on the third fret on the high E. And you repeat the same strumming pattern. Now, to get it sounding exactly like the original, you're gonna wanna hit the open G, which you're not fretting, but within the strumming pattern. It will sound like this. You hit the two top strings, and the bit that you would normally sort of go down to another note, you're not going down to another note, but you're aiming to hit the open G string like that. So it's gonna sound. And you can hear how I hit the G string in the place where we have been going down to a note. So and you repeat that twice. So the three shapes together. That's the rhythm guitar for the whole verse. So all we've got to do is add this little riff on the end, which is what I'm going to teach you right now. Okay, so now the riff. This one's going to be a hard one if you've never done these sort of fast alternate picking riffs before. You want to make sure, first rule, that your right hand is doing alternate picking throughout this riff. Try and be strict with that, down followed by up each time. With the left hand, it's all centered around the low A and D strings here, all around the sort of second fret area. Sounds like this. That's how it sounds. Let's slow it down. First fret, second fret, A string. You release, open, which should be an up stroke, back down with a down stroke. Then you have to roll the finger to hit the D string. So you've got, then it's open again, and then the open string, the open A string underneath that. So you've got, that's what you want to work on, nice and slow. Try and mute the notes as you go along, because if you're not strong with your left hand, it's going to sound like this. All the notes ringing together, whereas you want to try to, if you can, whilst you're practicing it slow, try and keep things under control. Use a mixture of palm muting on here, and also left hand muting to try and stop the notes ringing out against each other a little clearer. And that riff is used to separate out all the sections. And you want to get it to sort of, it's quite a fast riff. It's not an easy riff, that one. But you want to make sure that you take it nice and slow. Learn the riff slow and gradually speed it up, making sure you're playing it accurately. Try to mute as much as possible. Practice with the metronome might help. Your intermediate guitarist, so you should be familiar with that. If you've never used it before, you might want to take my beginner guitar course, which is totally free, rexpearson.com. And for the true masters out there who really want to nail this song, don't forget that this song will have a mastery pack which you can get from the website, rexpearson.com. Follow the link if you're watching it on YouTube below, and you'll be able to join the website and download a mastery pack which will have all the chords, all the tabs, all the shapes, all the lyrics, all the riffs, my warm-up exercises to help you get this nailed, a ton of other things that are going to really help you to nail this song, because it's not an easy one. Video lesson is great, but the mastery pack is what you need if you want to actually perfect the song and know what you're doing whilst you're doing it. Okay, so you've got that riff. After that riff, you're then going back into the section. And there's always this open A string going on before you repeat the riff. So as you play the last part here, so you play that little open string just before you come back into the main riff. Okay, now, the guitars, rhythm guitars, are playing what we've already learned, but there's a little bit of a twist in that the lead guitar plays something a little bit different. That's what I'm going to teach you right now. So you should have the intro, you should have the chords, which, well, not really the chords, but the sort of two notes strumming thing that's going on in the verse. This part is all to do with what the lead guitar is playing over those verses. Use your ear to find out when it happens in the song. Sounds like this. First finger on the second fret. And all you're doing, alternate picking throughout. Fourth finger comes down on the fifth fret. Then back down on the third, on the second fret there. Next part. Exactly the same rhythm, exactly the same shape almost, but just repeated a little bit higher. You change string to the D string, fourth fret, and then seventh fret is what you're reaching for with the little finger. So that's the first two shapes. Then you change position. You've got your second finger on the third fret, and your first finger gets ready on the second fret below it, all on the D string. And you repeat that twice, that little end part there. And then you've got this open string thing happening from the chords. So you've got. Open. And then you repeat the riff again. Second time it comes around, and always on the second time. So when you get to this part, you then play the signaling riff. You then play that little signal riff at the end of the second repeat.